Welcome back to Tagata Pasifika. Last night, Sita Selupe was named a Blake Leader Award winner for her work in education. The prestigious honour recognises Sita's work, which spans two decades and includes setting up the first Pasifika charter school. We'll talk to Sita shortly, but first, this from Sanja Kailahi.
Sita Selupe's goal is to raise leaders, one child at a time. It's also the mission of the Rise Up Academy, the first Pacific charter school in Mangere, which opened its doors last year. Sita is the principal and CEO.
This, more than anybody else, to have the first Pacific primary partnership school. So we were elated, but we also knew that the journey ahead of us was not going to be easy.
But the actual journey for Sita started with a homeschool she ran from a garage on a Saturday morning, using inquiry-based learning and problem-solving.
What that means is that for our children, we realise that they learn quicker, faster, better when their learning is real practical and hands-on learning for them.
70% of the children from year 1 to 6 are Pasifika, and the remaining are Māori. The school's vision, sharp minds, strong bodies, good hearts.
What we are doing, it's not rocket science. It's just Pacific community and Pacific teachers who understand how to engage Pacific whānau, and greeting them and receiving them at our school gates and our office with the same cultural understanding and perspective and responsiveness that makes them feel welcome in the school.
New Zealand-born and of Tongan and Niuean descent, Sita also raised four children while working tirelessly behind the scenes to bring her goal alive. Last year, Sita was named Next Magazine's Woman of the Year. Now she's been recognised as a Blake leader.
Well, joining me today for our Talanoa is Sir Peter Blake Leader Awardee Sita Selupe. Welcome to the show. Now, how was the award last night? You received the Blake Leadership Award. What does the honour mean to you?
Well, last night was amazing. Sir Peter Blake is a prime leader of New Zealand, and one of his sayings that stuck with me last night was, "Will it make the boat go faster?" And I think in leadership, specifically with Pacific, we really need some of our children and our students to accelerate their learning faster.
Awesome. Now, you also won Next Magazine's Woman of the Year last year. Now, with these awards behind you, what does that mean in terms of finally being recognised for the work that you're doing with Pasifika children?
You know, Susanna, as Pacific woman, it's in our blood to serve our family and serve our community. And sometimes it's not because we want to, but it's because we have to. It's the way the Pacific women are raised. And so I think it's a celebration of not just myself, but the community, the village that support me.
Correct. And now let's talk about the school. Now, I know you've been on TP a few times, but Rise Up began as a school from your garage. Now, how did you get a home school into a fully blown charter school? How did that transition happen?
Well, we've been working with over 200 families now around South Auckland. It was actually a few mothers that asked us if we would consider opening a school. So the journey has been one long, challenging, but very rewarding one, and not without the support of our current Pacific leaders from South Auckland.
Awesome. Now, fast tracking to today, you've had the school opened for over a year now. Now, tell me a little bit about the results. How are the children, what are the achievements like?
So at this point in time, well, we had our first year of measuring our children's performance standards against the national standards, and we've come out with about 90% of our students at or above in reading and about 80% in reading and writing, which is phenomenal for Pacific Decile 2, 3 in South Auckland.
That's awesome. Now, I know that the charter school is still, there's some controversy around it still. Now, what are your thoughts on why Pacific children are excelling at your school compared to those who are in mainstream?
Well, the vision for our school is sharp minds, strong bodies and good hearts. And our approach, when we say to whānau, when you enrol your child, we, the school, enrol your whānau. And it's really important that we get that support from our parents. And we've got some parents in our school, they just bring their A game to school. And so it means it increases the expectations of everyone, our teachers, expectations of parents, parents' expectations of teachers and so forth.
That's fantastic. So basically you're saying you've got to have that wraparound support of both the family, the parents, the even grandparents to grow these children into successful young leaders.
Well, that is correct, but there are three other aspects of our approach that we really try to reiterate to our community, and it's based on what Tomorrow's Schools is all about. Mm. It's about effective governance, it's about excellent teaching and learning, and it's about fully engaged whānau. So we believe that we've got a model of schooling that Sir David Longhi would be very proud of.
I'm sure he would be. Now, what are some of the challenges that you foresee in the future?
Well, at this time we're increasing our role, and our parents, they, large part of them are very, very confident in the schooling that we're currently providing. So they're asking us to take our students up to year 10. So that's part of our challenge, is to develop our model and keep the integrity of the Rise Up way and increase our role to go up to year 10.
Yeah, and you're doing so well because you've also increased your enrolments from when you first started last year from 35 to now, where is it sitting?
That's correct. So we started off with 35 when we opened our doors last year. And at the moment, we're going to open a new class, which will take us to 84 students.
That's fantastic in a year. Now, finally, what's next for Sita Selupe? What can we expect to see?
Oh, my desire is that we would see Pacific across New Zealand and across the Pacific Rim, and see how well do our Pacific communities thrive in the different education systems in the States, in New Zealand, or maybe even back home in the islands. And my husband has got some plans to go back to Tonga and do some work there, so no doubt I'll follow him there, and we'll see what plans unfold there.
Sounds fantastic. Thank you so much. Now, after the break, we meet the new Miss Apraxis.